How's it going, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Bill, and in today's video, we are doing something on the Bronco that I know some of you are going to say that's pointless and a waste of money. Why bother doing that? Some of you are going to be more along my side of saying, yeah, it might not be totally necessary, but it's not going to hurt, and I'm going to do anything I can to ensure the longevity of my engine as much as I can. And what that part is an oil catch can. Now, this is the 2.7, so I do realize it's not as necessary as it would be with the 2.3, since it is port injected and direct injected, so the valves shouldn't get too gummed up. But like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and do it anyway. I'm not going to go into a whole big discussion about the benefits of a catch can or anything like that. If you're not sure what they are, let me know down in the comments below. We can have a discussion there, and you can tell me about how they're not needed in the 2.7 engine or how you would do it yourself. Not going to get into that all right now. Instead, we're just going to go ahead and get into the installation. I went with the Mishimoto one. For a couple reasons. I like Mishimoto as a company. I like their parts. I've used their parts in the F-350. We'll probably be doing more parts from them for the Bronco. Most likely the intercooler when they come up with their new version that they're working on. But for the oil catch can, it should be pretty simple. I've seen a couple come on the market where like the can is mounted up here towards the front and it uses really long tubes to connect everything. I like the Mishimoto one because it mounts in the back. What we're going to be doing is the PCV side. They do have a dual can coming out, which will do the CCV and the PCV side. But they just have the PCV side available now. And all we're going to do is remove this hose, put the catch can, so run a hose to here and to the can and from back from the can to here. So basically it's putting the catch can in between there to try to catch any condensation, oil, anything like that. So let's take a look at what's in the kit. I'm not sure if there's instructions in there or not, so I went ahead and printed some out. This looks like it's got a couple of nuts and washers in there, a couple zip ties, and a bracket. The hoses, a couple of aluminum fittings, and I assume the can itself. This will collect any condensation oil in here, and then you can just unscrew it and change it out. Normally you would just do that every time you do a oil change. Just make sure you check this, make sure you dump it out. It should be good. With these, I expect they would collect like a fair amount. You know, some vehicles you might have to change it every 1,000 miles or so. I would expect with the 2.7, it's probably every oil change should be more than enough. Unless you're going bigger turbos or like really over boosting the engine, then you may need to change it more often. But that's it. Like I said, I did print out the instructions because I had a feeling there weren't any in there. So yeah, like I said, I'm removing this hose. So there you can see there's oil blowing out of there, blowing through there. Now it should get washed off your valves. and not get gunked up. But I think it's better just not to have it in there at all and have to worry about it. Now that we got their hose off, it says to cut this zip tie. Free that up. I assume we take this off. All right, so yeah, take this off and then remove that nut. It's 10 millimeter. All right, so the directions don't go into a whole lot of detail from this point. It just shows you a picture of the can installed and says, use the provided hardware and install it to look like this. But pretty sure it's self-explanatory where this is going to mount onto the provider, onto those studs. Include it washer and nut on there. And same thing on this side. I'm just gonna come over to our can. It looks like that is a 17 millimeter. Good, tighten it down. And then it looks like these screws that are already in there is what's gonna hold these to the mount. So let's find too small. All right, I have no idea. Yeah, there's no, this is just out of my random drawer of random hex bits or Allen wrenches. So I don't know exactly what size that is. It's pretty small though. Just tighten those up. And there's our can. Mount it. All right, one thing I did miss in the packaging, they did have these worm gear clamps in there. So we can install one. Each side. And so these are just going to clamp on and then push that. And that'd be the same thing this side. Now it doesn't say anything in the directions, but we did remove this clamp, this wiring harness, and there's two of these zip ties of the Christmas tree, and it looks like that could just go right through this hole that they've provided. That's what makes the most sense to me. considering that that's the kind of zip tie they provided. And we disconnected it, or undid the zip tie that was holding that wire loom. And there's a little provided hole there, so I mean, that's what makes sense. Now whenever we want to change this, I can just screw that, and then we can check whatever we've got in there. Do a quick start. Alright, everything seems to be running like normal, which I didn't expect to change anything, but just need to double check that everything's running. No warning lights. I got about 1,000 miles left before I'm due for another oil change, so check it then. Do a oil change, check it then, see what the catch can looks like, see how full it is, see if it actually even catches anything with this engine. I'm not expecting it's going to catch a whole lot, but like I said, I'd rather err on the side of caution and have it and not need it, rather than find out too late that I've gunked up the engine and I could have prevented it in the long run. Anyway, that's going to go ahead and wrap up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that thumbs up button. Let me know if you'd like to see more videos like this in the future. Hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.